Hi, and welcome to 3dmotive.com. My name is Stephen G. Wells, and I'm a senior character artist. In this little tips and tricks tutorial, we're going to take a look inside 3D Studio Max to use a feature that a lot of people kind of gloss over and don't bother using. It actually comes in really handy for a lot of different things, so I'm going to go ahead and show you soft selection. We'll just do a few things in it just to give you a basic understanding of it, and kind of just go from there. So I'm just going to select this sphere. It was a default sphere. I converted it to an editable poly just by right-clicking on it. Convert to editable poly. Okay. If I hold down the, if I click the one key on my keypad, that actually gets me into the vertices. That's right where I want to be. I'm going to go right in here, soft selection. If I click the button that says use soft selection, we're ready to go. It's just that easy. I'm going to turn off my snap toggle. Let's just grab a few vertices in here. Now, as you can see, the vertices become red. The edges are yellow, but these edges are green. That's because these are the vertices that are going to be affected the most. The yellow is what's going to be affected the most. But the green is the fall off. It's the tapering. So if I scale this up, as you can see what goes on, see how it goes from yellow is the area of the most influence for the soft selection. Green will be is the fade off to a bluish to a dark blue. Okay, so you can imagine if you just keep scaling this up, you can actually do the whole sphere. But I don't think we want to go necessarily that far. But you can see where it's simple. Just by scaling up the fall off, you can really affect a very wide area or drop it down to something a little bit smaller. In this case, let's just go up a little bit. Okay, we're gonna just lock this selection. For me, it's the space bar to lock and unlock. Okay, but we're just going to keep that locked, and let's go ahead now and just move this. So as you can see, it's fairly fluid. Now obviously it helps with the more edge loops we have and the more vertices we have. Gives you more of a shaping of the mesh as you're working it. If you're working something really low polygon, you're not going to get quite something as fluid as that, but you'll still get something pretty fluid. You can actually squeeze it in and invert it. You can actually do animations this way too. It's a nice way to set up some animations, you know, some bounciness on the ball kind of thing. All right. What you can do too is this is the curve. This is the selection curve. So as you can see, if you can imagine it, it's not very relevant here. It starts to get relevant and then is really affected and then falls off. That's about what this curve is. If we turn up the pinch, say, let's just crank that up a little bit. Now you can see how it pinches that. If we now pull this, you can see that the rest of the area that was affected before isn't quite as affected, and it actually kind of pinches that area. Okay, if we crank it up more, it's really gonna, now you see it starts to actually pull in opposite direction in the blue area, so it's actually working converse to what you're pulling out. So again, depending on what you're trying to work with, if you're trying to get a really organic alien landscape or something, this might be a way to get some of those shapes in there. You can go into negative numbers too, by the way. If you just put in the negative point there and now pull it out, and now you're getting a reverse. It's now pulling it out as the center area, the center mass is being pulled. It actually is pushing itself in as the rest is pulling out. Excuse me, and you can see that based on this curve here. All right, so let's go ahead and turn that down on the pinch. For the bubble, let's go ahead and turn that up to say 50. This has a really interesting effect. You can do a lot of different things with bubble. Imagine, if you will, it's kind of like what it says. It's a bubble and it affects things in different ways. Let's just try and grab one vertice and see what it does. As you can see, it just kind of bubbles out. Literally, bubbles out, bubbles in, starts to affect it. But you can see right here, you can see that, well, for starters, there's not enough vertices to support me moving the polygons in, but you can also see that it's a much sharper delineated line of where the areas are being affected for this particular with this particular setting, this bubble. So it's one of those that if you want to ever play with that, you know, you want to experiment with it first before you actually use it to any great length. Control Z. Okay. All right, you can actually do it. You can grab a whole section up here. If you hold down your, for me, it's the space bar. If you hit Control X, you can go full screen just so you can see what is going on. And if I hit X here, I get my gizmo, my little move gizmo. So I'm going to zoom out, and I'm just doing that with the wheel mouse, the middle mouse. Okay, so now I can just pull this up in one direction. And you can see what you can do with it. I mean, you can do a lot of good shapes. If you were trying to get something like a Fabergé egg kind of thing, you know, you can just stretch it up. You can actually do it in specific axes. You can do the same for over here if you do it this way. You can just moving it in the X. So there's a lot of different things you can do with it. Hit X to turn that off. A lot of different ways you can go with using the soft selection. By the way, they also have this thing called edge distance. If you turn on the edge distance, this shows you, I'm just going to select one vertice. This shows you, if I turn off the edge distance, you see it's a much broader area is going to be affected, even in a general sense, with just one vertice affected. If I put on edge distance, it's literally limiting that to like one vertice out. So I wouldn't get quite as an effect on that, unless of course I scale it up. So I can keep scaling it up to a certain extent and then move it out as I need to. But overall, it doesn't have the same soft selection, so to speak. It doesn't affect all of these vertices in the same way. Even as I pull this out, it's really focused just in this one particular area. It doesn't affect even the vertices in the bluing. Whereas again, if I turn that off, now I get a different effect. You see how the whole thing is affected? It's a gradient. It's a gradient fall off, but still, it's a great feature that they have in 3D Studio Max, and it's something that I actually like to use in certain instances. Let's go to something else. We're going to go ahead and turn off the sphere, and we're going to turn on. I'm going to hit Control X to get full screen. This is a low resolution. It's an in-game basketball caricature model that I did for a game. It was just supposed to be done. It was funny. It had funny proportions, etc. Just to show you what you can do in this. You zoom in, let's say we'll go ahead and get into one. I'm going to hit Control X just to make sure. I'm going to select the top polys here of his head. I'm going to just lock those. We'll just scale this up a little bit this way. You need to do like something. Now, as I scale this head up, you can see how it tapers down to the areas unaffected until it's not affected at all. Let's do that again. See? The region, as it goes into this middle light blue, as I was doing that, you can see it goes from the green in the middle to that light blue before it goes to the regular dark blue of it. It's much, much less affected in that area, so it scales it out. And you could actually end up, you know, with really cartoon proportions, really fun cartoon proportions on the particular character. If we go ahead and get out of this, you know, you could have something fun like that. Back into the into editing the vertices, you can do that. You can actually, if you want to create better shoulders, better biceps, or something. Let's go ahead and just do the shoulders a little bit. I'm going to crank this down a little, and I'm going to scale it up. And I can grab this one, and I can scale it up. I can grab his forearms and pull them out a little bit. Same over here. And pull them out a little bit. Okay? you know, make his arms really beefy. The same as you could do, you know, make his calves a little thicker, etc., etc. It's just, the list is endless on what you can do with the soft select. Okay, let's go ahead and try one last model. We're going to turn that off and turn on. This was a boomer model I was working on. In this case, I actually have half this model is instanced. Actually, let me close this. I'm going to just ungroup it. If you see, when I select one side, the other side isn't affected. The head is its own mesh, so I'm not worried about that. In this case, sometimes when you're working with symmetry, it's good to work with something like the soft selection if you're working with something like that, because you can grab your vertice or select the soft selection and grab a vertice, and whatever you do on this side then is obviously automatically affected on this side. It saves you from doing twice the amount of work, kind of thing. So you can scale it up. Now this is one of those things too where you can have your edge distance and you can sort of make sure it's going to affect only certain things. In this case, I'm affecting just this shoulder piece, and now if I move it up, let's scale it up a little bit, and it's scaled up on that side. Soft selection is a really great tool, especially when you're working with symmetry, for you to rescale things as you need to. Like if you grab this foot here, you want it to be a little bit wider, we can turn it down a little bit. Get into our move tool, make sure we're just on the X. If you hit control, just X, I mean, again, you can just scale this out. I'll grab just a few vertices there and scale it over this way. And then he's ended up having some massive feet. Okay, we'll pull this forward a little bit. Yeah, then he's going to have some super massive feet. So, soft selection is a really great tool. I like to use it a lot when I'm working with organic shapes. Also when I'm working with having to realign. Sometimes when you're working in ZBrush, your models thin down a little bit after you subdivide them, and then you bring them back into Max or Maya, as case may be. And so sometimes I like to go back in here and flush some of this out and, you know, build it up a little bit extra and then save the file. But anyway, that was a very, very quick introduction into the dynamics of soft selection in 3D Studio Max. This has been 3dmotive.com, and my name is Stephen G. Wells.